Hello, eighth graders, our Eckstein class of 2021. As your principal, I first want to acknowledge that this was not the eighth grade year any of us expected for your final year at Eckstein Middle School. COVID-19 certainly changed the trajectory of your eighth grade year, and you've handled it with grace, you've shown grit, and been as positive as you possibly could be in our new world of remote and hybrid learning. I know you've missed the normal, everyday moments at school. Getting close in space to your friends as you greet each other in the hallways, between classes, or in the garden at lunch, and before and after school as you greet each other at your lockers. For those of you on campus with us this spring, you did a fantastic job of keeping that 6-foot distance between you and your peers. I asked some of your eighth grade teachers to describe you as a cohort. Here are some of the words that they shared with me: energetic, cohesive, fun, resilient, easygoing, unflappable, hilarious, adaptive, consistent, resourceful, flexible, savvy, gracious, and forgiving. As I completed year-end reflections with your teachers in the past couple weeks, over and over again, I heard how much they enjoyed you as a group of students. You are a special group of students who are going to go on in the world and do great things. As you move into your high school years, you will have a multitude of opportunities and possibilities come your way. Grab a hold of them. Meet new people. Don't procrastinate. Use your planner. Get involved in a student activity, group, or sport. Ask questions, stretch your comfort zone, help others, and step up and engage when times are the toughest and injustices stand in front of you. Listen, learn, and act. On behalf of your Eckstein staff, we thank you, we celebrate you, and we can't wait to hear about all your future adventures and all of your successes. Now it's your time to fly, Eckstein Eagles. Go get out there in the world and do great things. Thank you.
Hello, grade eights. I can't believe it's been almost 2 years since we got our rock and roll on at the Mopop, learned about Seattle from above and below at the Underground Tour and the Seattle Observatory, and tasted the fabulous fare at the Chinatown International District. You are an outstanding group of students with the opportunity to change the world. I have every confidence that high school is going to be a dynamic and fun experience for you. Remember when you get to high school to enjoy yourself and get involved. Study hard and make sure your dreams are in the front of your mind as you make your way towards adulthood. Respect yourself and each other. Don't forget to be a good friend. And most importantly, love yourself and love your families. With that, I'll say, take care and see you later. Don't forget to stop by occasionally and say hello. Bye, guys.
Eighth graders, you've been through so much the past couple of years, but I'm so proud of you, of where you are and where you're going. I have a little poem to share with you. I'm going to read part of it. It's from a book, so I'll read the beginning and the end, but I highly recommend you check it out. A Place Inside of Me, A Poem to Heal the Heart by Zetta Elliott, illustrated by Noah Denman. There is a place inside of me, a space deep down inside of me where all my feelings hide. They wait there in the darkness, a knot of electric emotion, seething, sizzling, burning, until I find the strength to reach inside. There is peace inside of me, a calm deep down inside of me that flows through my soul like a tranquil stream and hushes my whispering doubts. There is compassion inside of me, a tenderness deep down inside of me that tries to heal the wounds of the past and to forgive in spite of the lingering pain. There is still hope inside of me, a promise deep down inside of me that I will use my life to help others and they will help me in return. For there is love inside of me, true love deep down inside of me, I am in love with my people, all people, plus trees, sparrows, sunlight, and the rain that falls like a blessing from above. And when I look inside of me, to that place deep down inside of me, I remember to love myself most of all.
Hi, eighth graders. Congratulations on your 3 years at Eckstein. I'm sure they're not exactly what you expected them to be when you first started. I saw many of you in sixth grade, and I certainly missed the opportunity to see you walking down the hallways each of the following years to see your growth as a young person. But I did want to share, first of all, my congratulations that you made it. And I wanted to share a couple words of wisdom from two of my favorite sources for philosophy. One, Winnie the Pooh, of course. Promise me you'll remember you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think. And also from another favorite of mine, Dr. Seuss, you have the brains in your head. You have the feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. Though your journey at Eckstein is coming to an end, it's just the beginning of new heights for you. Continue to be dedicated to who you are and who you want to be. Work hard, be nice, be kind, enjoy each other's company, and experience all there is to experience in high school. It'll go fast. Find something you are passionate about and live a good life. Be nice to each other. This is the beginning of anything you want it to be. Take care, best wishes. I wish you continued success and a successful future. Best wishes, Mr. Jacobs.
Hi, Eckstein 8th graders. First off, congratulations on making it to 9th grade. This has definitely been the most wild 3 years of middle school that any middle schooler has ever experienced. You've done in person, you've done online, you've even done hybrid, and it's made you better people and global citizens for it. I look forward to hearing all the accomplishments that you all achieve in the years to come. And just remember that this is a speed bump in the road, and you have many more successes and things to look forward to in the future.
Hello, 8th grade students. The resilience and determination that you guys showed during this pandemic was truly inspiring and gives me tremendous hope for the future. I can't wait to see the great things that you guys are going to do.
Hi, 8th graders. Congratulations on your upcoming promotion. I'm so proud of all your hard work this year. Have a happy and safe summer, and I wish you all the best in the future. Adios.
Congratulations, 8th graders. We'll miss you so much, but we know you're off to do great things in high school and beyond. Good luck and keep singing.
Congratulations on making it through one of the most difficult 8th grade years of all time. This accomplishment is just one of many that you will make as you continue your adventure. Celebrate the goals that you met and consider the goals that you did not meet as lessons. If you learned only a few things from your science classes, I hope it was that perseverance is the road to success, and of course, yes, you can. I'm lucky to have been able to see you grow up these last 3 years, and I wish you all the best. Congratulations, everyone.
Happy, 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 happy! Happy graduation!
All right, hello, eighth graders. What a strange and in some ways an amazing year. Definitely has been interesting to be teaching remotely for so long. You guys did a great job learning what we needed to learn. And it was great to come in at the end of the year to see many of you in person and live and no longer virtual. I wish you all the best in upcoming years. And just one thing to remember is this. If you never fail, you're not trying hard enough.
Hello, 8th graders. 'Tis I, Mrs. Clark, your language arts teacher. It has been such an honor and privilege to be your teacher this year. I know we have all done the best we could given the trying circumstances. When you see me out and about, mostly at the Safeway on Roosevelt and 75th, please stop and say hi. Make sure to tell me your name. because while all of you know what I look like, most of you have only appeared like this on the screen, so I would not recognize you. Have a restful summer and enjoy your first year at high school that will hopefully be 100% in person. Goodbye, my little chickadees. Here's an inspiring quote to send you on your way from my You Are Believed In book. I'm gonna stop it right here. But friendship is precious. I don't like that one. Okay, let's try again. The creation of 1,000 forests is in one acorn. And that is from Ralph Waldo Emerson. Bye.
Hi, eighth graders. I just wanted to send a big, huge congratulations as you head up to high school and graduate from just a wacky year. And I hope that down the road, when you look back and think on this time, you remember that we all learned some pretty important things during this time together, separately, over teams. And here's hoping we don't have to do teams again for quite some time, and that maybe these masks are going to be eventually a thing we only wear when we're sick. But anyways, big congratulations to you guys, and have a great high school career wherever you go from here.
Hey, eighth graders, congratulations. So excited for you on this great new adventure. Good luck at high school. We're gonna miss you here, but we're so excited for this next season for you. You're awesome, and keep being awesome.
Okay, so how's my hair, Miss Alsep?
Your hair looks wonderful.
Fantastic. Yours too, super.
Thank you. Okay, we're ready to go. Good morning, eighth graders. I'm here to wish you on your way to high school. It's been a great year. I wish I'd got to know you better, but I'm sure you're gonna do great.
Hi guys. Remember me? Some of you might have had me for science last year. I know I got to see you in person just a little bit, and then pandemic and all this hit and things got weird and online, and then suddenly we didn't see each other again. So I hope you have a great time in high school. It's fantastic and beyond. Good luck. Best wishes. Go Eagles!
Hello, eighth graders. I'm Mrs. Port, for those of you who don't know me, and I just wanted to say congratulations on making it through probably the weirdest middle school experience of anyone's life with the pandemic and leaving halfway through seventh grade and just kind of having a little bit here at the end of being back in person. And I just want to tell you how impressed I am with your perseverance and with your enthusiasm for learning, and I hope you don't lose those things as you move off to your high school career. I found a quote from Thomas Edison, and he said, "Many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up." And my wish for all of you is that you also don't give up when life gets hard, and that you continue to persevere and follow those dreams that you have. And know that I and many of your middle school teachers here are rooting for you always. Congratulations. Bye, guys.
Soon to be high schoolers, now eighth graders. It is with great pleasure I get to bring you this short message. First, stay curious. Second, learn from any mistakes or failures in your future. We had a lot of really fun times working with you here at Eckstein, and I really hope to see you guys in the paper, on the telly, for all of your future achievements. Just be sure to represent yourself, your families, and your community as you move throughout your education, and don't forget to stop by if you're ever wanting to see us again. Otherwise, thank you so much. I hope you have a fantastic and a successful future ahead.
Hello, dear Eckstein 8th graders, class of 2021. What a year you have had. My hats go off to you managing to survive this pandemic, potentially not intact emotionally, or perhaps you have the unfortunate distinction of having lost a loved one to this terrible disease. in this time of reflection, in this time of moving forward, it can be difficult to really see the growth that you have made. It can be difficult to find things to celebrate when, as a nation and a world, we are mired in so much loss. Nonetheless, I ask that you do find time to seek out the good, to notice yourself and to notice the steps that you have made to grow over the course of your entire middle school career. With that, I do have some thoughts for you as you move forward into the next phase of your academic and social life. Do not be afraid to fail. Make sure that you take risks and you try new things. Most of the time when people find themselves towards the end of their lives, they regret the things they did not do much more than the things that they did. I would ask that you stay curious and ask questions, seek answers, and be a lifelong student. Focus on paying attention to those around you and making sure that they are in as good a place as they can be. If you see someone heading in the wrong direction in their life, ask them a question, talk to them, reach out to them, be a friend. Continue to read. Read voraciously. This is going to be a habit that you will use to understand your world and to understand the things around you. Everything from text message emojis from friends to The New Yorker to the newest, coolest anime or graphic novel. Read everything that you get a chance to read. Continue to do so. And also write. Write a lot. Write journals. Write papers. Write notes. Write cards to people. Do a lot of writing. Be kind. This is crucial. All that you will see in the world may work to make you a jaded person. It can, but only if you let it. If you look for the dark, it is all that you will see. If you seek out the light, you might just well find it. If you have a problem, find a trusted adult to help you. You are growing in your independence, and you will soon be faced with adult situations. But you are not yet experienced in all things. Seek out those who do have that experience and take their guidance, take their advice under advisement. This is not to say that every adult has all the answers. Of course, we do not. But as a curious individual, as someone who seeks to learn, the best achievement that you can have would be to be able to learn from the mistakes of others so that you do not have to repeat their trauma. Work to become financially independent. Work to become physically independent. Work to become capable. You are capable of so much already, and that is only going to grow and continue. Read. Did I say read? Read. Read a lot. Write. Write a lot. Write to your representatives. Write to your family. Write to your friends. Write to us. Tell us how you're doing. Tell us about high school. Tell us about baseball or a book or anything. Keep in touch. Believe in yourself. Trust yourself to do the right thing. Believe in yourself. Believe in those around you. And believe, most importantly, in the fact that you matter. Believe in the fact that you have come through this year that has been more difficult than any, certainly in my life, and arguably any in the lives of anybody who is alive today. Believe that we matter and believe that we will find a way. Thank you. Congratulations.
Congrats, eighth graders. Nice job making it through this crazy year. Good luck next year at high school. I know that all of you are going to do such an amazing job. Good luck.
Congratulations, eighth graders. You did it. You made it to high school. I'm so proud of all of you. I hope you all have an awesome summer.
Hey, eighth graders. Mr. Charlie here.
And Miss Daniela.
We wanted to wish you guys the best of luck in your high school years.
Yes, we'll miss you at Eckstein, but good luck on your next adventure.
That was the one.
Hello, eighth graders. It's me, Miss Carpenter, your sixth grade teacher for language arts. I want to congratulate you on making it through middle school. These are tough, tough years, and this year was especially grueling. But hopefully, you have some good memories. Parts of speech, flip charts, home of the brave, and all of the wonderful things that happened, not just in eighth grade or seventh grade or sixth grade, but all throughout your time at Eckstein. And remember, somebody else's opinion does not have to be your reality. Have a great one, and please come back and visit. We're going to miss you.
Hey team, it's Ms. Hufnagel, and I saw some of you in sixth grade, and boy, has a lot happened since then. Congratulations on persevering and making your way through Eckstein in these most unusual times. And I look forward to clear skies ahead and seeing you all come back and visit maybe. And all the best to you in high school and beyond. Make it great.
Congratulations, eighth graders. It feels like just yesterday that many of you were in the art room, and I remember you really fondly. I hope you have great things ahead in high school and beyond, and that you have a lot of fun this summer. Congrats.
Hi, eighth grade. Congrats. You did it. You are graduating. You made it through this wild, wild year. This year just brought on all of the difficultness and hardness and punches, and you guys did it. Like, you succeeded. You made it through to the very end. Thanks so much for hanging on. Thanks for all of for making this online teaching experience as good as it could possibly be. I had so much fun with you guys this year. Really. I truly, truly did. So thanks. Thanks for all the laughs, for all the memories, and congratulations. You're graduated.
Hey, eighth graders. Woo! You did it. Congratulations. What a wacky year. And you did that. So you're going to high school. Congratulations.
Hi, eighth graders. Congratulations. This is Miss Levine with just a reminder that you matter. Don't you forget it. You matter. You're made of matter, and you matter. So enjoy.
Hi, my eighth graders. I'm gonna miss you so much. I've loved seeing you grow from sixth grade into seventh graders, and now eighth graders ready to fly on to high school and beyond. Things that you're gonna go on to see. As you see, I've got my UW hat on. I'm a proud Husky. But whatever you do, through high school and beyond, I know you'll be fantastic. I've loved having you. I've loved getting to know all of you, and I'm so proud of you all. Have a wonderful summer and a fabulous high school, and take chances, say hi to new people, invite someone to sit with you, be an includer, and have a wonderful, wonderful time.
Hi, eighth graders. It's a nice warm day out, so I'm nice and shiny. I have for you some pieces of advice as you go become a freshman. Bender's gonna help me out here. He's hot too. Number one, my grandfather always used to tell me, life is a numbers game. So if it doesn't work the first time, actually keep going. Number two, my other grandpa told me, if you wanna achieve something, you have to put the effort in. Now more than ever, you can do it, I promise. Number three, my grandma. A lot of old people told me stuff, which is great. They knew stuff. My grandma always told me, she was married to a stubborn man, you can be right or you can be happy. And if you're lucky, sometimes it's both. And then my best friend growing up, who used to get injured a whole lot, he used to tell me, go fast, pull up. And he always used to remind me, safety third. That's all I got. Good luck next year.
Hey, eighth graders, I just wanted to let you know I am so happy to have had you in my class this year, and I really appreciate how you, at the beginning of this crazy year and then online school, you all made me feel very welcome and comfortable and accepted, and that's been great. And I am so happy that I got to meet a few of you when we got to come back into the building, and I'm so sad I didn't get to meet the rest of you. But I hope you have an amazing time in high school and beyond. And remember, high school is only a small blip for the rest of your life. So make the most of it, enjoy every minute, experience as much as you can, and have a blast. And again, thank you so much. I have loved every minute of my first year at Eckstein with you all.
Hello, eighth graders. This is Ms. Savage, wishing you a great, great, exciting new adventure in high school. Congratulations, and have a wonderful, wonderful summer.
Eckstein eighth graders, it's Ms. Kazala. Some of you know me as your sixth grade math teacher. Some of you know me as your seventh grade math teacher. Some of you just know me from the halls, and some of you know me as Kale's mom. As you go off to high school, enjoy being around each other again. Look out for each other, take care of each other, be kind, be curious, and we always like to know how you're doing. So come back and visit, or just check in and let us know how you're doing. Have a wonderful summer and good luck next year. Bye, guys.
Yay, you finished middle school. Congratulations. I am so sorry that circumstances meant that I couldn't be with you in the building this spring, seeing your bright, shiny 8th grade faces, but I am very grateful for all the time that we spent together in 6th grade and in 8th grade, and I am grateful for everything you taught me about how to be a good teacher, and I am grateful in advance of all of the things that you're going to get up to this summer when you're taking care of yourselves and having some fun, and in high school and beyond. You've got a lot to do, but you're going to be amazing.
All right. So my name is Anne Ioannidis, and I am in charge of presenting the Ruth Ann Allen Award this year to two eighth grade students. In September of 2015, Eckstein sadly lost a beloved member of our staff, Ruth Ann Allen. Ruth Ann had been a teacher at Eckstein for 13 years, and throughout those years, she made an indelible mark on countless Eckstein students. While language arts and social studies were the subjects she taught, she also gave lessons in life. Delighted to be assigned to students with more significant struggles, Ruth Ann taught our kids that in life you never give up. When times were rough and things weren't going their way, our young men and women learned from her that perseverance, grit, and a sense of humor would be their guides to success. To honor Ruth Ann's legacy, Eckstein staff would like to present an award to two eighth grade students who have fought through adversity to show outstanding academic, social, and emotional growth during his or her time here with us. The following students were nominated by the teachers at Eckstein: Sabir Abdul Rahman, Naomi Gonzalez, Cash Lexing, Khalil Tate, Anthony Washington, Aliyah Harrell, Lily Kimbrough, Kauser Osman, Belen Sime, Mohammed Suma, Jameer Walker, Fardosa Bariso, and Levon James. Congratulations to all of you. I am proud to announce that two students were chosen to receive this award in 2021, and they are Sabir Abdul Rahman and Lily Kimbrough. Thank you very much.
Everyone, every spring, Seattle Public Schools, in conjunction with the Memorial Fund, managed by the Anti-Defamation League, honors elementary and middle school students who epitomize the value of Seymour Kaplan. He was an outstanding community member and dedicated his life to human relations, helping people overcome prejudice and accept differences. This award honors two people in eighth grade, with the recipients being forever honored on a plaque in our main office. And Eckstein staff nominate these kids, and the eighth grade class votes on them. I think that this is the most important award in Seattle Public Schools because it's an award about what kind of person you are, not if you are the best at sports or you have the best grades. These are the qualities that kids were asked to vote for. Does the student care about his or her classmates, particularly those who are less able? Does the student share materials as well as himself or herself? Does the student admonish students who call names or try to stop disrespect to others? Is the student special to other students as well as the adults? And is the student able to cope with factors outside his or her control? And do they practice and live this continuously? So these are the names of the nominees. They are Alex Chidiak, Aaliyah Harrell, Alice Einhorn, Olivia Wagner, Aurelie Segura, Belen Sime, Chloe Mai, Claudia Serenzia, Dee Sherlock, Ember Hartel, Hagar Gamaladin, Jake Torrey, Josie Charette, Justin Davies, Kai Davey, Khalil Tate, Leola Hannock, Lily Kimbrough, Macy Runyons, Mikkel Lindsay, Mason Weingartner, Nellie Fawcett, Nora Wilson, Renna Kaminsky-Willard, Talia Goslin, Tijar Emmanuel, Tony Fuse, Wiley Smith, Will Arnold, Will Clark, and Zach Brown. And the winners of the two winners of the Seymour Kaplan Humanitarian Award are Chloe Mai and Hagar Gamaladin. Congratulations to Chloe and Hagar. I'm so proud of you. You deserve it, and all of the eighth graders thought you did too. So congratulations.
Hi Eagles, I'm Jane.
And I'm Nellie.
And we're this year's co-presidents. Congrats, and it was such a great year.
And now we're off to high school.